in terms of what researchers should do, they should be very familiar with the research agenda, and they should ensure that the agenda is relevant to the development needs and the challenges that are specific to a certain organization. If the organization is government, whether it's county government, a ministry, or whichever institution, the research agenda must be relevant and very relevant to that. They must also make sure that the quality of the research that they do is comprehensive, and it is having in-depth, and it is offering alternative solutions to the decision maker. And the third thing they should do is that they should make sure that the information that they have researched on is available. This evidence must be available. So mechanisms of dissemination should be put in place so that the results of the research can be shared. This could be through conferences, workshops, and retreats, or web portals, or such kind of blogs and things of that kind. Now, when you come to the area of what researchers should not do, one is that they should not design their own problem to research on, or their own problem statements, but it should be a problem solving which is based on some practical need, so that it can meet, the results can meet a certain need. The secondly is in terms of the design. They should never compromise design. The design is very key, and in terms of design, so that it can meet the needs. So probably it would be very important to ensure that the design is discussed with other experts so that the information that will be elicited from the research can be relevant to the subject area in terms of design. And finally, what researchers should not do is to finalize and perish, what I call finalize and perish. And this is in terms of doing research and failing to have the mechanisms of sharing the evidence that they have gathered. So we should always ensure that research is shared, and the mechanisms of sharing them must be put in place, must be part of the design of the research itself.